only part is concerned is of those accounts are under there. A sort of like the AK-47 is a, you know, stone in the hand of the security force and keeps the security. The moment the hand is staying, it goes to a terrorist that belongs to the destruction. So in the case, we need to blame technology and social media and all that. But good part is that here we have got the opportunity of making this out of it. Just I can say that this is a platform which is available throughout the day, 24/7, instant, and we can have a larger audience to deliver our message. That is the best part. Coming back to the good point about social media as a faculty, because I am a teacher also and I do teach insurance and marketing subjects. The best part I feel that having the social media is make us very acceptable to our own students. We feel part of their own group, and that gives us, you know, youthfulness is always there. The best part, the second best part is that at the click of the button, we have the accessibility of so many good research paper articles available in our mobile. In the morning, I do read whatever has come from the Wall Street Journal, New York Times, Financial Times. Since I am from insurance, but now CIIE network. And whatever good is for my student, the first job perhaps after coming from the Barfumi.
A WhatsApp group which is existing for some of the institutions. And the type of messaging which goes there, which are sometimes quite negative in nature. Not only negative, but quite negative, because I have an access to see many of these comments in many of the WhatsApp groups. Unfortunately, unfortunately, as a part of the higher education forum. And they're extreme, they're not only mischievous, but they're damaging. The damaging to individuals, the damaging to the institution. So what happens is, if there is a comment against me, I get hurt as an individual. You may say, well, it's a part of life, that's the way you should take the life. But sometimes some of us are not in a position to take that lightly, and therefore a sense of diffidence comes in between the teacher and the student. So I think that mindset should also be there, that this is a social platform, an informal platform. People say good things, people say bad things, see the bad things in front of you. If we go with this mentality, go ahead with this particular mentality, I don't think this type of comments do cause a problem, but I have seen that this type of comments are come against individuals. I'm not really talking about institutions. I'm talking about individuals, and that creates a problem. So that's the second thing. So that is also a question of mindset, that how do I take that negative things, how do I learn from it, and how do I take it forward. Third, social media marketing as a group, academic group, it can never succeed unless and until the institute management provides enables an ecosystem. You know, it's an ecosystem actually creation, because when I say ecosystem, I'm talking there are two types of ecosystem we define. There is a physical ecosystem and there is an academic ecosystem. When I say physical ecosystem, I'm talking about uninterrupted, let us say 20 Mbps, 20 Mbps, 30 Mbps, 100 Mbps, internet facility. That's what I'm talking about, the physical ecosystem part of it. When I'm talking about academic ecosystem part of it, I'm talking about giving a freedom to the teachers, giving a freedom to the teacher to experiment with a certain new type of methodologies which are available in this. So that type of support from the management is not there. And that we see a little bit of resistance from some of the managements. I'm not talking about all management. Many of the managements are highly progressive in nature. But there are some of the managements still they're resisting, still they're insisting for the classical methods of classical. So that method, that hurdle should be created from the management. These are three main hurdles. But I still feel it is the mental setup. It's a more of an attitude. If we cannot come out of that attitude from only being formal and dictatorial in nature to an informal, social, informal orientation in nature, that means this relation between the teacher and the student should become completely different in this era. That is what used to be, let's say, 20 years before. When I started my teaching, I used to come ask students to stand, I used to take a blackboard and sign. Those days are gone now. And I must understand the hassle of it. Just last comment, you know, this is not practical experience I'm talking about also. That if you are using a mobile in the classroom for the purpose of solving an exercise, let's say I'm doing a finance exercise calculating an IRR, and the Excel spreadsheet is opening in the mobile. I'm using it, and students are using it. There is a possibility that 20% of the students are on mobile, but they're not using the Excel, but they're doing CAD. So therefore, that's a hassle. So that mentality you must change as a teacher. That happens, I don't think there are much to worry.
Dr. Kulkarni, you have been heading this university for a long time. And as the university is very progressive on digital front, I would like to understand, and the audience would be happy to know, if you can elaborate something on strategic fit of social media into your university on a strategic level.
Is there establishment of this particular feature and incorporation of that, and making university ready for the adoption of the social media is a major challenge. I think processing the tool is basically the management who has to be proactive, and they have to provide the required facilities. And it's not going to be easy task like that, but today I'm trying to that I want to incorporate social media into our system, and tomorrow it's going to be done. But there is effort which is involved. The effort would be in terms of providing the required environment and the facilities in the university where the social media would be made use of. For example, we can make a policy that laptops are going to be available, and everything has to bring the laptop. And when the students or the faculty members of the event, they bring the laptop, if I don't have the environment where the laptops are going to be used, and they could be made use of, then it's going to be useless. And also we discussed about using the smartphones and other things in the classroom. When they are going to be used, and what is to be used, and for what kind of environment that particular facility has to be used, and they have to provide it. And now that's going to be the major challenge from the university point of view. That you have to provide the required environment, which is being done in Neva University in a different way. And other one is that changing the mindset of the people, which is going to be the major task. It's not going to be only telling the students that you use this. And making students to use that, so the mindset of the faculty members have to be changed. Until now, the faculty members were very, very happy with the just check and board kind of teaching. Maybe using some kind of the PPTs and then telling that they are digital. But the future is not going to be that. Expectation of the students from such a incorporation is being changed. And every time when you look at the students, it's not going to be what is written in the curriculum book or say the so-called syllabus book. It is going to be making them to learn and then something beyond the curriculum. And for that, what could be done? I mean, for that, the faculty members have to be ready first. Even training the faculty members and then making them ready for the adoption of social media, I feel that is a major challenge, which is the challenge for the university also. And by telling this, I mean, whatever the risk factors, for example, I adopted the social media, and if I don't be alert with that, for example, we are putting lot of their posts in the website, and many things are being done. And if they're not being updated regularly, and every day there has to be some kind of adaptation, every material that's going to be given, it has to be new and it has to be fresh. And we should attract the people to make use of that. And for that, what university is going to do? And even providing that itself is going to be another major challenge. It is not going to be like, I mean, only taking mission like, okay, so we are going to incorporate social media and it's going to be used. But for that, I mean, there is a lot of preparation which is involved. And there is a commitment for that. And then preparing students towards that, and preparing faculty for that, and even telling the management the advantages of getting into social media. And I told about the admission and then marketing. And from 333 to taking even the application ratio to 60,000. And earlier we were working with 1:2 student application ratio. And now we have about 1:5, 1:6. And maybe in future it may increase. You are telling the advantage of that. I think that is also going to be the major challenge. But I feel there are challenges, but the challenges could be addressed. And that could be done. And with that we can make universities ready for adoption of the social media.
How do you see the academia in this coming decade?
I've been in industry for a long time, and many innovations come, many changes come, many new technologies come, and how do we react, and how our adoption takes place? In my understanding, when new technology or new solution comes, you go through three stages. In first stage, you use new technology or new ways. Try to help you make current things more efficient, more cost effective, so that you can compete better. That is what is happening right now in adoption of IT into even academics, you know, when you are looking at admissions, placements, management of the institute, etc. Making the current processes more efficient is the first stage. Second stage is when you start adding something more to the current offerings or solutions. You know, you for example, cars now, it's not simply cars, you start, you know, offer entertainment system into it, you offer GPS into it. New technology adds to existing solutions to make them more attractive, more wholesome. Same thing is probably will happen over here, where social media, computers, IT, internet will be used to increase the way teaching can be done. Like sir talked of using mobile phone in the class simultaneously to solve your problems. Those are the kind of things which in my time were unthinkable. So you are adding more to what is happening. But the third thing, which is the one has to be careful, that when existing companies are trying to become more efficient or adding more things, some new fellow comes and disrupts the whole market by offering something which makes the existing things irrelevant. You know, that is the cusp, that is the turning point when it happens. You know, when for example, in music industry, you had cassettes and then you had LPs and then you had DVDs, CDs coming in, people were trying to make them cheaper and more easily available, and suddenly you had Apple coming up with a digital player and the whole old business became irrelevant. So the question that I am grappling with, you know, that comes to my mind is, in what way the current form of teaching will become irrelevant with new industry? You know, that's what we have to grapple with. And to me, if I have to look at it very simply, for too long we have seen, we have defined the purpose of education, you know, as Gyan Mandirs, temples of knowledge, where people come and we offer them knowledge, they gain knowledge and we test them how much knowledge they have gained. So when people go out, they are more knowledgeable. And we have measures, you know, the marks that you give them, the degree you give them, that's a sign of how much more knowledgeable are they now. To my mind, that probably will start becoming irrelevant. Then we'll have to start, because the knowledge is going to be available so easily. Therefore, the fact that you are more knowledgeable doesn't make much sense. So what is going to be important is, the words that come to my mind is, you take people and can you make them more innovative or more better problem solvers. That will have to be the way of measuring. That when your students are going out, are they more innovators? Now, if you have to do that, your whole way of teaching has to change. Your subjects have to change. Your way of engaging with students have to change. You are not engaged in your course. You know, structure is not on what you are going to give inputs on. Your structure is going to be, at the end of this course, what kind of new things that a person can handle or tackle. So, there are going to be many disruptions coming, where teachers will have to learn different ways on how they are going to teach. And engagement will have to change. And you have to assume knowledge is available, the internet is available, everything is available. Therefore, what? So, similar kind of thing is about vocational courses at one level. We'll have to take it to much higher levels of study. This way, I think one will have to address.